Katerina.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you. Great
Welcome
to be here.
Welcome to A Coffee with Celine. You are the first Australian woman winning a Grand Prix. Historic?
Yeah, it's awesome. Like, I was so excited about it, so happy. All the hard work paid off. Very proud for my country and all, like the team and everyone is very happy about this.
Yeah, we too. And Katerina, you have a funny story. I mean, a special story. You are a citizen of the world.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah,
You were born? Yeah.
I was born in Germany, in Hamburg, but my dad is Australian, so I always had two passports. And we decided in 2014 to represent Australia. So I went to Australia, became in 63 the first one, and then I started representing Australia.
Born in Germany, Australian, and where do you live today?
In Luxembourg.
Yeah, funny. Why Luxembourg?
Yeah, my coach is also my partner, and last year he became the national coach of Luxembourg. So we moved, and now we live in Luxembourg, train there. But pretty much we train all over the world with all the training camps and competitions.
And so this victory in Tel Aviv, it was a trigger, a click for you?
Yeah, it was very special for me because yeah, it's the first one. I'm so proud of myself that we achieved this, me and him, and like also like Australia achieved this. So yeah, it's great to be finally at the point to win like big competitions.
And when did you start judo?
I started judo when I was 6 years old. I was like full of energy when I was a kid, and my mom, I think she was very annoyed with me because I was jumping up and down the house. So she was trying to get me involved in sports. I was trying a few things, but judo, I fell in love straight away. The whole sport, like all the values, it's great. Like the friendship part, like traveling the world, it gave me so much opportunities, and also I grow as a person. I think this is the main thing. Like judo shaped me so much, made me so resilient. Never giving up. Like keep dreaming and pushing forward.
You love it right away.
Right away, Yeah, I started with a friend and she stopped after 2 years, and my mom was like, do you want to keep going? I was like, yeah, no question, I want to keep doing. Like, it was hard to get me off the mat.
And when did you realize that judo can be more than a passion?
I think that was when I first got introduced to the regional center in Hamburg, where I grew up.
How old were you?
About 14.
Yes.
I'm not quite sure, but it was pre-cadets. So I picked up training a little more than just twice a week. Mm-hmm. It was for me always like, I was a big passion, but school came always first. So I wasn't like other cadets or juniors. So I wasn't training in the morning because I went to a normal school.
Okay.
I still always had the dream to make it to the German national team, but did not quite work out.
Yes,
I was simply not good enough at that point.
And do you know already what you are gonna do after competition, after judo?
I'm studying sports management right now. So after the Olympics in Tokyo, I wanna have a little break and finish my studies. I'm not quite sure what I will want to do with it after, but I'm pretty sure I want to move to Australia afterwards and have a job there, something with sports.
And for vacation, which country? Apart from Australia, of course.
Yeah, well, I would always go to Australia. It's the best country in the world, telling you. It's so beautiful. The people are so nice. They're always welcome.
And if you weren't a high-level judoka, who would you be?
Actually, never really thought about it.
Yes, perhaps another sport, champion? Or
maybe another sport. I was playing some soccer when I grew up.
Really?
I really like that, yeah. I think I wasn't that bad, but like I had to choose, and then I chose judo still.
Do you have some routine? I mean, are you superstitious, or do you need some lucky charm in your bag when you go for a competition?
I'm trying not to, because I'm very forgetful, so sometimes just leaving stuff at home.
Oh yeah, really?
Yeah, so, I'm mostly have the same hoodie with me. And like a little lucky charm, like a teddy bear.
Yeah, a small one.
Yeah, small one.
So it's a toy when you were a kid, or
no, it's a gift. It's a gift from family.
Yeah.
So yeah. It's actually like a teddy and like a gymnast outfit. I'm trying not to do like have too many routines because every time it's a little different, and sometimes like my luggage got lost a few times.
Yeah, yes.
So you can't do anything against that.
And with the person you owe everything, I mean, who was the most important person to making you a champion?
Of course, my parents. They supported me all the way, they support me all the time, but I think my coach and my partner, Alexander Lüdecke, I think he's the most important person in the world for me. He pushed me, like he always believed in me, also when I did not believe in me. So without him, this wouldn't be possible. I wouldn't stand here.
Mm-hmm. And during the competition, you watch some TV, series, video games perhaps, gamer?
During the competition? No, not really.
Or before?
Before, like, I watched Friends sometimes, the TV show Friends.
Yes.
This is for me very easy and entertaining. But like during the competition, I just try to like nap in between and just keep calm, but not really watching anything, listening to music.
What kind of music?
Oh, it's all over the place, so different. Whatever comes up, I'm not really having a playlist or anything. I just like chuck everything together.
And before a big fight, you need to be motivating by special music?
Yes? I always listen to one song, it's called Beast, but I'm not sure who sang it. I'm not quite sure.
But it's like rock?
It's more like a hard song.
Yes. Let's talk about Tokyo. Is it your dream now, more than a few weeks ago?
It actually became very real now after winning the Grand Prix in Tel Aviv. So now I'm like, I actually am at the level, I match everyone pretty much. I haven't fought a few of the top level players, but I'm keen to fight them. And I think I can match everyone now. So I'm looking forward to fight the next competitions and also hopefully get away with a medal. A good result in Tokyo.
Thank you so much, Katarzyna. It was a pleasure. Good luck.
Pleasure to meet you.
On the road to Tokyo.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Thank you.